Hi students, I'm Dr. P.A. Rajeshwari, Assistant Professor in the Department of Food Science and Nutrition, Avinashalingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. I welcome you all to E-Parshala. Today, we are going to discuss about the structure of wheat. The cereal grains are seeds of grass family. The word cereal is derived from Ceres, meaning Roman goddesses of grain. The principal cereal crops are rice, wheat, maize, jowar, ragi, and bajra. Wheat is a grass widely cultivated for its feed, a cereal grain which is a worldwide staple food. There are many species of wheat which together make up the genus Triticum. The most widely grown is the common wheat. Wheat grains have either a dark orange-brown appearance or a light yellowish color. Wheat belongs to the genus Triticum and there are 30,000 species. The wheat produced in the country belongs to Triticum acetivum, which accounts for 95%, Triticum durum, which accounts for 4%, and Triticum dicocum, which accounts for 1%. Depending on the soil, climatic conditions, quality of seed, and farming techniques, wheat varies widely in its properties. It is grown on more land area than any other food crop. World trade in wheat is greater than for all other crops combined. In 2016, world production of wheat was 749 million tons, making it the second most produced cereal after maize. Since 1960, world production of wheat and other grain crops have tripled and is expected to grow further through the middle of 21st century. Globally, wheat is the leading source of vegetable protein in human food, having a protein content of about 13%, which is relatively high compared to other major cereals and staple foods. The ease with which wheat grains produced and stored together with relatively low cost and nutritional contributions has resulted in widespread. Use of wheat and wheat in the staple food in the diets of most growing populations. When eaten as the whole grain, wheat is a source of multiple nutrients and dietary fiber. Regular consumption of wheat fiber is associated with lower risk of several diseases, including chronic heart disease, stroke, cancer, and type 2 diabetes. In a small part of the general population, gluten, the major component of wheat protein, can trigger celiac disease, non-celiac gluten sensitivity, gluten satisia, and dermatitis herpetiformis. There was a time when many countries preferred white seeded wheat. Nowadays, this preference has gradually disappeared and mainly golden brown colored varieties are grown nowadays. Wheat is generally classified according to the color and hardness of the grain. Hard wheat yields flour that is high in good quality protein such as gluten, has high water absorption power, good mixing and fermentation tolerance, and has good retention power and is excellent for bread making. The other type, that is soft wheat, have lower amount of proteins and absorb less water. Such flours are good for cakes, soft dough, biscuit and cookies, but unsuitable for bread making. Now, let us see the botanical classification of wheat. Wheat belongs to the kingdom Plantae, unranked as angiosperms. Order is Poales, and it belongs to the family Pomaceae, and the tribe Triticiaceae, and the genus Triticum. Coming to the classification of Indian wheats. Wheat is an annual plant of Germaceae family. Although as many as 18 species of wheat have been described and recognized, only a few are of agricultural importance. They are discussed as under. First one is emmer wheat. This is reported to be grown in certain areas of southern India, that is Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. It is good for South Indian dish upma. Next is macaroni wheat. Cultivation of macaroni wheat in India is considered to be very old. It is the best wheat for drought conditions or under restricted irrigation conditions of Punjab, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, West Bengal and Himachal Pradesh. It is used for semolina. Common bread wheat. It is the typical wheat of alluvial soils of Indo-Gangetic plains, that is Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and few parts of Rajasthan. The bulk of Indian crop therefore consists of this type. Indian dwarf wheat. This belongs to the club wheat of Western countries. This is grown in limited areas of India and Pakistan. These are characterized by very short and compact heads having shorter grains. Mexican dwarf wheat. This is presently grown in almost all the wheat growing zones. This wheat was introduced in India by Dr. Ni Bolrang of Mexico. Nowadays, it is the most widely grown wheat species in India. It covers more than 87% of the total wheat growing of India, followed by doodrum wheat and dicom wheat. The most common wheat which is good for chapati making and bakery products is grown in the whole of North India and also in Central and South India. Now let us move on to the wheat structure. The overall structure of wheat grain is basically simple. The kernel of wheat is usually 1/8 to 1/4 inch long. In some kinds of wheat, the tip of the each kernel is covered by stiff hairs called the brush. Wheat grains are ovoid in shape, rounded in both ends. Along one side of the grain, there is a crease, a folding of the aleuron and all covering the layers. The physical structure of wheat consists of three important parts, namely bran, which makes up to 14.5 to 15%, and the majority of the portion is the endosperm, which contributes about 83% of the whole grain, and the last is the germ, which accounts for 2.5%. The grains develop from flowers or florets, which are enclosed in a pair of brackets or leaves called jima and pele. The ovary and the ovule within it, after fertilization by pollen grains, develop into the grain. In wheat, the jima and pele become free from the grain at threshing and from the kerf. Here, it is said to be naked grain called chiropilis. The brackets adhering to the grain constitute the hull or husk. Wheat consists of fruit coat, pericarp and seed. The seed comprises the seed coat, germ and the endosperm. Each of the main parts of the grain, pericarp, seed coat, germ and endosperm, is divided further into various layers, tissues and regions. Now let us see the parts in details. Bran or pericarp. Bran is made up of six layers. The outer layer of the wheat consists of thin-walled, long, rectangular cells. Next to the epidermis is the hypoderm of varying thickness. The innermost layer of the pericarp tears during the ripening of the seed And in the mature grain, they are represented by a layer of branching hyphae-like cells known as tube cells. The pericarp of wheat is thin and papery. Seed coat. The seed coat or testa, thin layer or double layer, is often deeply pigmented, which gives grain with the cellular structure almost obliterated. Next to testa is the hyaline layer, also called as nuclear layer, which is colorless and devoid of any obvious cellular structures. The inner of testa of wheat is often deeply pigmented, which gives grain its characteristic color. The fourth layer testa contains the coloring matter, which decides the color of the wheat and also could influence the color of the flour. It is rich in sterols, accounting to 1% of the epicarp. The outer epicarp constitutes to 3.5% of the pericarp. It is rich in insoluble dietary fibers such as xylans, cellulose and lignin. Antioxidants such as phenolic acids are abundantly bound to the cell walls in the pericarp. Next we will move on to aleuron layer. The endosperm is surrounded by one or more layer of cells known as aleuron, which is the sixth layer, which contains protease enzyme that has softening effect on the floor proteins and consequently on doughs. In wheat, aleuron, a single layer of thick-coated cubical cells, constitute 7% of grain weight. The cells contain about 20% of each protein, oil and mineral. Insoluble dietary fibers and very few soluble fibers such as xylans and beta-glucans, phenolic compounds, lignins, vitamin E, B vitamins and various plant sterols are also present in the aleuron layer, and 10% of sugar, particularly sucrose, neoketose and raffinose, are also present. The cells are also rich in nicotinic acid. The aleuron cells also contain tiny grains of phytic acid with some protein. The aleuron layers generally surround only the starchy endosperm. The aleuron layer and all the covering external to it comprise the brawn. Although brawn is nutritionally rich in B vitamins, but the cellulose material of brawn tends to speed up the passage of food through digestive tract, reducing the total nutrient contribution to the body. The sharp edges of the brawn fragments have a cutting action on gluten strands, reducing the gas retention power of the dough. Due to these reasons, it is not desirable to have brawn contamination in the flour more than what is absolutely unavoidable in good milling practices. Endosperm. The endosperm itself consists of cells of various sizes, shapes and different composition. The endosperm cells consist mainly of starch and protein, the starch being in the form of spherical granules, which are single granules or tightly packed together and embedded in a matrix of protein. The size and shape of the starch granules in the endosperm cells vary from one cereal to another. Starchy endosperm accounts for about 80 to 85% of the grain. Endosperm is the floury portion of the wheat kernel, and flour for bakery and biscuit industry is produced from this part of the grain. The endosperm is the potential white flour within the center of the wheat grain. When milled, the endosperm fractures along the cell and separates from the brawn layer. The ease of separating the endosperm from the brawn layers is determined by the wheat's characteristics. Hard wheat will allow easy separation, while the endosperm of the soft wheat does not separate as cleanly from the bran layers. Next, we will move on to embryo. The wheat germ is the embryo that could eventually develop into the wheat plant. The germ or embryo consists of many parts and account for 3% of the wheat grain. It is separated from endosperm by scutellum, which has the functioning of mobilizing the stored food in the endosperm and transplanting them to the embryo when the grain germinates. The germ and scutellum are rich in protein and fat, while most of the B vitamins in the grain are present in the scutellum. Germ contains oil, which reduces the keeping quality of flour. Hence, it is desirable to remove germ during milling process. It is rich in certain vitamins, protein and oil. Consequently, it is often used in health foods such as fortified bread and wholemeal flour. Now, we will have a look at the classification of wheat according to the kernel structure. The wheat is classified into 5 types, namely very soft wheat, soft wheat, hard wheat, medium hard wheat and very hard wheat. Now let us have a look at the byproducts of wheat. After milling of wheat, the various byproducts are obtained, which are as follows. Whole wheat flour. It contains the finely ground bran, germ and endosperm of the whole kernel. Whole wheat products have a distinct flavor and coarse texture than those made from white flour. Because of the higher fat content of the germ, whole wheat flour is more difficult to keep and sometimes becomes rancid in storage under poor conditions. Wheat flour is fortified with defatted soy flour, maximum up to 10%. This not only improves quantity and quality of protein but also improves functional characteristics such as moisture retention and less oil absorption in the end product. Iron fortified wheat flour has been successfully used to prevent iron deficiency anemia in some Western countries. Next is maida. The bran and germ are separated in making white flour or maida. Maida bakes more uniformly into a loaf of a greater volume and it is more bland in taste and more easily digested. It can be stored in airtight container or in a refrigerator. Semolina. It is coarsely ground endosperm and its chemical composition is similar to that of white flour. It is used in the manufacture of macaroni products. It is roasted before storing to save it from insects and worms. Macaroni products. These products are also called pasta or elementary paste. These products include macaroni, spaghetti, vermicelli and noodles. The main ingredient in the macaroni group of products is a special duodenum flour of high gluten content. Macaroni is a tube form. Spaghetti may be either tube or rod. Vermicelli is a tiny rod and noodles are flat strips. Pasta products are also available in the shapes of shell and alphabets. Glutamic acid. It is derived from wheat. A familiar compound of glutamic acid is monosodium glutamate, a salt-like product generally available and used to bring out flavor of other foods or seasonings. Wheat germ. Wheat germ is about 2-3% of wheat grain. It has a high nutritional quality compared to animal proteins. Wheat germ can be used in bakery products and weaning foods. Wheat bran. It increases the stool weight by increasing the water holding capacity of the bran. Wheat bran prevents constipation and may lower the risk of colon cancer. To conclude, wheat is the commonly grown cereal and widely used by different populations across the world. Due to improvement and advancement in food processing technology, the outcome of byproducts of wheat has increased a lot. Extrusion technology supports the wheat processing industry in bringing out new innovative products attracted by customers. Thank you.